Yes, it's Australian soccer's biggest day in 4 years and one of the biggest days in its history. Welcome to our live telecast of the Crunch Match on Australia's World.
Suspended Robert Zabica, while Adelaide City pair Milan Ivanovic and Tony Vidmar come into the defence. Zelic moves to the midfield for the injured Paul Okon, while Vidmar replaces Milan Blagojevic. Canada has made one alteration for this game, their 14th World Cup qualifier this year. Missing from the Canadian lineup is John Liniatis. The number four, Nick Dusovic, moves into his position at left midfield, while Fortuna Sittard defender Randy Samuel is back from suspension. Samuel will mark Socceroo captain Graham Arnold. Obata, the second youngest FIFA referee from Japan. The Socceroos sporting their new strip from Adidas. As the chant goes up here at the Sydney Football Stadium, all in readiness for Australian soccer's biggest game in the last 4 years. It was here where Israel ended the hopes and dreams of a nation. With that match ending in a 1-1 draw, Australia needed to win, as they do today, to march on. The winner over two legs will go on to play a third place side from Peru, Paraguay, Colombia or Argentina. Paraguay is currently third in that group in South America. As Jurakovic gives the ball to Milan Ivanovic back in the side. His last starting international was against the Solomon Islands. And already some confusion at the back. Farina, he'll keep it in and he couldn't get it to Arnold. And away there by Samuel. A good sign for Australia early on. Zelic, Van Blerk. The elegant skills of the Borussia Dortmund sweeper Zelic. Tony Vidmar. Tobin. Tough one for Slater. In there was Sweeney. Bunbury on and out of play. Tony Vidmar. The last time he played in the same international side with his brother was against Argentina last year. And Robbie Slater gets his cross in too close. Keeper just made sure of it. Blake Forrest, 6'5", Canadian keeper, the tallest player on the pitch. A long ball over the top of Tobin. Bunbury waits for support, and there was Tobin. And commitment there coming from Ned Zelic. But now Hooper, good jink inside. Commitment also from Ivanovic. Zelic, cool play. Slater. Arnold got his right. Through the middle, Van Blerk. Van Blerk will be the goal! Oh, what a save! What a save from Forrest. Australia, 1:50 into the game. It was almost 1-0, a replica of what we saw against New Zealand.
An excellent start, Andy. The boys have taken it right to Canada, and the fact that Van Blerk involved in the attacks indicates that a very positive attitude from Australia, but a splendid start by them.
And now the header! Vidmar and Farina came through. Frank Farina out to prove a few points to some critics. who were disappointed with his form last week. It's all Australia. Early days yet, but what a change it makes to come back home to your own backyard. No smiles yet. The house is looking fairly safe for Eddie Thompson. Zelic already involved in a couple of strong physical challenges. Slater chasing down Sweeney. Interception by Tony Bidmark. Ivanovic. Arnold trying to get it off to Slater. Samuel there. And that'll be a good duel as well, John. The Samuel-Arnold duel. They've played against each other four times in Holland when Arnold was there with Roda.
Well, it's important Arnie as the skipper and as the key player has a big game. He, by his own admission, it was a quiet one for him and many others in Edmonton. But a good start, Andy. We've already had two strikes on goal. And the hunger's there, the tackling. And the fact that everyone is just so positive in an attacking sense. They've let Canada know that they are playing away from home. Established the authority, and it's important now to consolidate on what's been a good opening 3 minutes for them.
A long ball for Farina. Easily cut out by Watson. Van Blerk there. Vidmar looks on. Farina's onside. Arnold's in the centre. Farina, he might have it himself. He lines it up. He's side. And touch. Australia again. Graham Arnold came through the centre. What a dynamic start from the Socceroos.
Well, in Edmonton, Andy, we didn't have a strike on goal. We've already had three in the opening 3 minutes. The fact that Farina is very active at this stage is a good sign. It was a quiet game for him up in Canada, but he's out to prove that he is our leading striker. And his combination with Arnold up front already, their mobility is causing a lot of problems in the Canadian defence.
Dasovic on for Bunbury. Inside for Hooper. On the right is Mitchell. Ivanovic away for Australia. Arnold and Samuel. Up with Samuel. Now Vidmar. Vidmar's got Farina ahead of him. Blocked. Watson the culprit there.
And that should be a yellow,
Andy. That's a yellow card, really. Surely it is. He was on his way to goal.
It's a professional foul. And we go back to Edmonton where Zabika was sent off. But this is a professional foul. No intent to play the ball. Just to deny Vidmar a goal scoring opportunity. And should be a yellow card. Good start by Australia. They've got Canada on the back foot. It's easy to say, let's get a good opening to the match, and it's not always so easy. But Canada already on the back foot. And so many involved in attack, not just Farina and Arnold. We've seen Van Blerk, we've seen Vidmar is quite busy. Slater. But it's important to consolidate and hopefully get that all-important first goal.
And you just wonder if Australia can get that first goal early, how many more might come after that. Zelic with a free kick. Looking for Arnold. Samuel's there with him. Away by Samuel. Surprisingly, no midfielders there waiting at the edge of the box. And a handball against Slater. And Robbie Slater, I should point out, was in a bit of doubt for this game. He had a hamstring injury. But Slater was checked earlier this morning and was given the okay. Arnold and Samuel. It looked like Samuel was hanging on to Arnold. Mobilio back. Great turn by Bunbury. The advantage roll. In comes Mitchell on the chance. And Schwartz has got down. Well, Canada could have hit Australia there. It was Bunbury who played the role of creator. And Australia, perhaps, lucky not to concede one.
That's what they've got to be careful of, Andy. All that takes is that to upset the game plan. The good refereeing allowed the advantage for the foul on Bunbury. And a tremendous save from young Schwarzer.
Tony Vidmar, his first game at right back. at all major levels of international football. Gallop away, Bunbury up, in was Van Vleuten. Saw the flag from Mr. Yamaguchi, just maybe a little bit late on that far side. Australia's eighth World Cup qualifier in this campaign, and for Canada, they've had 14 qualifiers this year. Remembering, of course, that Canada needed to win their last game against Mexico to go straight to the USA 94 finals, but Mexico ended up winning away from home 2-1. Canada had led 1-0. Hooper. Away by Miller. Sweeney down that left flank, and free kick has been won by Tobin. Arnold and Samuel. Sweeney across in cover for Canada. There was Tobin. Now Vidmar inside for Slater. Oh, what a challenge. That's surely got to be a yellow. And Sweeney giving Slater a few words as well. There's no need for that, really. That was some bad challenge from Sweeney. The Canadians involved in a war of words, which is foolish in this sort of game. But, you know, Sweeney is having a bit to say to Slater, and there's no doubts about the foul.
Well, it was either yellow, did appear double-footed even, Andy, very late above the ball. If we weren't Australians, we could argue it should have perhaps even been a sent-off offence. Very, very poor tackle.
Well, the referee hasn't pulled out the cards as yet. There have been two challenges, which looked a bit like a yellow card offence. Ivanovic, Farina away, Arnold and Samuel. Away by Samuel, Slater across. And the ball cleared away by Miller.
Have a look at this! Have a look!
10 minutes into the game. No goals. There could have been two for Australia at least, and perhaps one for Canada. The fans are certainly getting value for money. Farina. Slater. Looking for Arnold. Samuel there for Canada. The keeper comes. So does Farina. Big Craig Forrest quickly away from his goal area. And Luke behind the clearance. Dragovic back there. Van Blurk, Vidmar, Dragovic. Good searching ball for Van Blurk. The keeper's come out of his area. And the second time the keeper has made runs when he should have stayed in that goal mouth. He's just mistimed his runs, the keeper, and Frank Gallup will be happy that they've only conceded the throw-in. Van Blurk. Farina. And away by Samuel, the corner. Second corner of the game, Hodgman to Australia. Slater goes near post. Zelic. Vidmar. Direction not there. Always hard with your back to goal. We know what sort of shot Tony Vidmar has. A lot of money invested in this team, John, and to be quite honest, they have to really get past Canada to prove exactly how good this team is. You've played in a few Socceroos sides yourself, and they call this team the dream team and perhaps the best team to represent Australia.
Well, I think potentially it is. I don't think there's any argument with that. They still yet have to do it. But the investment angle, or people regard as an expense, it's not really. It's an investment to make the World Cup finals. The rewards, not just monetary, but promotion-wise for the game here, should they make it, are quite immense. And that's the way it is worldwide, Andy. A lot of money required, a lot of preparation time, a lot of travel. And the ASF, to their credit, have given this team every opportunity to succeed.
How did you find the pay dispute saga? Badly timed?
Well, bad the way it came out publicly. Players are entitled to market price, the same as everybody else in this stadium is. Or airlines or hotels or whatever. It's just sad that it came out publicly. I think those matters should be decided privately. Should also be decided before the whole World Cup campaign starts. But it was sad that it came out that way. But players are entitled to be compensated for their skill. Everybody else is, and they're no different.
Good start for Australia. It's hopping away. Zelic with the overhead looking for Slater. Slater will get there because Arnold was being tagged by Samuel. Farnell can get Slater away. He's on. Slater should have the pace for Samuel. Well, the linesman didn't signal at all. The referee was at least 40 metres away from the action. And it's an Australian throw. Farina. Dasovic gets it back for Sweeney. Vidmar keeping it in. That's class play from Tony Vidmar. Dasovic fouling Tony Vidmar. Interesting story there. Nick Dasovic had trialled there with Dinamo Zagreb and had played with Zeljko Adzic, who was a former player of the year and a former Socceroo. Slater free kick. Farina, a little nod on there. Vidmar. Well, Aurelio Rabat back for Zelic. Van Bloem. Good idea, just pull out the defenders. Farina. Farina. Still gets his cross in. And again, the corner. What a game for Frank Farina.
And great to see, Andy. Frankie, the last few times for Australia has been a little below. He's the first to admit that. But really buzzing today. He got a point to prove. He's very mobile. I think it sort of suits him so much better having more support from Arnold up there. They're causing all sorts of problems for the Canadian defence. When he operates solo up front, it's much easier for him to be picked up.
Zelic. Well, Zelic slipped and Ivanovic has to chase back there. Ivanovic has found Slater. They head it through for Vidmar. And there was the defending from Hooper. Lovely ball from Ivanovic. The touch from Slater was perfect. And a great run through the middle from Aurelio Vidmar. Quarter number four for Australia. The match just over 15 minutes old. This time the long one. Tony Vidmar up there. Away by Sweeney. Ivanovic the last line.
Look at Whitey over and get Mike kicking off.
Well, not enough players dropping back, so smart move by Milan Ivanovic to leave it for Tony Vidmar. Australia are clearly the superior team in this one, but they've got to turn that superiority into goals. Zelic. Vidmar. The touch for Van Bloem. Mitchell's chasing him. It's gone his side. Not enough on it really to get to Farina. And that came off Tobin. But Australia, when they get down the flanks, Sean, they're opening up this Canadian defence every time almost.
And the contribution from Vidmar and Van Bloem on this side, I'm sure Geddy Thompson would be happy with what's happening. They're just opening Canada up so much. But as you say, Andy, it's a matter of converting the superiority. It's all Australia at this stage.
Break.
Jason Van Bloem. He knows how to score goals as well. He's actually scored two in his first game for Australia against Indonesia B 3 years ago. Dale Mitchell for Bunbury. Van Blurk on for Vidmar. How quickly can Australia break from the back now? Ivanovic is taking off. Down the line for Farina. Watson with Farina. Good clean challenge from the man who scored last week, a fortnight ago in Edmonton. Zelic. Van Blurk. Australia throw in. Most of the game has been in this half. Both teams have made it to the World Cup once. In 86, Canada was there. 74, Australia made it. A little unhesitating. Arnold. It's maybe the layoff. But when you're near that goal area, you try to set yourself up for the opportunity. It was a bit lazy, the defensive work from Canada, clearing that ball. They go for Arnold again. Came off Samuel Dasovic. Looking for Mobilio. I haven't seen him in the game today. And Dasovic has kept that run down that left flank. Bunbury inside for Dasovic. Looked like a handball. The referee won't play on. Up was Arnold with a delightful header. Vidmar. He was looking for Slater because Slater was free on that far right. That's smart play. Yes, it is, because there wasn't really enough support coming through, because you can see the consequence. Van Blurk's taken off. It needs to be a good one. Crashes the header against the post, and it fell invitingly for Farina.
The best move of the game for Australia, Van Blurk overlapping so well. Splendid cross. Vidmar hits it well, unfortunately strikes the post. But it's the fifth opportunity for Australia. It's all their game. They've just got to keep their cool. Just keep their cool, keep doing more of the same, because they've really got Canada against the ropes.
Yeah,
not to panic, those chances are going to be converted shortly.
Robbie Slater was saying that not to panic, exactly. First 15 or 20, don't panic if we don't score a goal. He's telling all the players in camp. That's been the general consensus of opinion this week. But the way Australia are playing, John, it's... you know, strong possibilities of perhaps 4-3 going in today. They've got to get the first one. They just might do it here, perhaps. Slater should have released a bit earlier. It was a smart challenge from Sweeney. Bunbury. Ivanovic flipping the heels of Alex Bunbury. For Bunbury. Now the shot from Mitchell. The 35-year-old midfielder scored a few goals in his time. 19, in fact, from the junior levels right through the senior teams. Always a tough ask for Graham Arnold. Mitchell, Bunbury, And again, another free kick. Canada is a bit unlike Australia, where we have a 14-team national league. Canada has formed with the United States a 17 competition, of which the Vancouver 86ers are leading, team coached by Bob Lenarduzzi. Nabilia. Been an interesting duel as well, Mabilio and Jurakovic. You just thought perhaps Jurakovic might have been the man to pick up on Bunbury.
Well, I know the basis Bunbury was the gun for Canada in the away leg, and Jurakovic such a good marker. But Eddie Thompson, believing that it was best to retain that marking system, perhaps Tobin in the air, probably better equipped to handle Bunbury than, say, Jurakovic.
Surely there was a foul there on Zelic. Referee again, eager to keep the game going. Here's Zelic now. Good touch on for Vidmar. Karina on his left. Looking inside. Initially it looked pretty good. But just curling away from Slater, and then his brother Tony Vidmar. Through the first half, no goals at the Sydney Football Stadium, but plenty of action, particularly at the Canadian end. Watson brings down Farina, and that's the second foul by Watson, in almost identical position to the first. And the dual strikers, Farina and Arnold, that's been a good ploy as well today. Arnold or Zelic, or perhaps Robbie Slater. Dangerous position. About 25 metres out. Arnold's drive. Going to take a touch. No. But a well-taken free kick from the captain. See here on the replay if it did in fact take a touch. No, it didn't. Van Blerk, one of the real performers today for Australia. Turns defence into attack, maybe. No, and it's header inside, covered there by Yellow, but that shows you the nerves at the back. The Canadian defence wasn't really tested that much in the first leg, but today they've been exposed a few times. Mitchell. It looks dangerous, but it went over the head of Mabilio. In was Zelic. Tobin's clearance didn't come off. Zelic again. Ooh, that was... That player should be booked for that. The captain should be booked. The referee's allowed play to continue, but when the ball goes out, I think the captain should be booked. Farina now for Australia. Blocked the first. Oh, Vidmar. That was the shot. Tony Vidmar back. Zelic might make amends. He shoots and taken by Forrest. The chance, really, for Vidmar to make up for that earlier header where he struck the woodwork. It fell invitingly for Vidmar, and maybe it was...
Wrong foot.
Yes.
Fell on his wrong foot. But I agree with you on the foul, Andy, on Zelic earlier on. I mean, referees should come back and book players for that. It was late. Canada, I feel, have been able to get away with too many fouls. And there's no yellows yet. And while there's no yellows, they'll continue to foul the likes of Zelic and Farina.
I'm surprised that they've really gone for the physical style of game against a side that is so fluent on the ball. And even then, some of the challenges are a bit late. The referee has not booked a player yet. There's been three instances where you would have expected it. Arnold, that's a good switch. Vidmar, Slater will pull across.
Yes.
Swatting it through for Slater. Samuel's come across though. The experience. Samuel is at best holding the fence together. He's pulled off some important clearances and has won a few balls in the air. Arnold on. And again, a miscue, the shooting a bit astray, and Jurakovic's clearance has fallen favourably there from Apilio. He's only player up there, but there's men coming through for Canada. This is dangerous. Zelic away. Ivanovic will keep the cool at the back. And Vidmar will take off now. Defence changes. The attack begins. Vidmar looks for Arnold. Samuel there. Hooper on. Mobilio. The captain, Miller. Yallop. It's a great pass. Mitchell. Down the line there is Mobilio. And Bloke looks for Arnold. It's a good header on, and Farina. Farina pushed by Samuel. Four chances, John, and he's having an absolute nightmare.
Well, from our point of view, he is. There's been somebody,
No, I'm not being biased. I'm being realistic.
Well, they have. Canada has been able to get away with it with the petty fouls, and there was another one on Farina, a very blatant one. And until they get the yellow, which puts them on the possibility of getting a red, they're just going to continue with it.
You know what will happen?
Australia will retaliate.
And they'll get a yellow.
Well, it's important that they don't retaliate, because if they do, they're sure to get the yellow. Players would be feeling a little bit, just a little bit down at this stage. They shouldn't though. They've done exactly what's required. They've opened Canada on the sides, particularly on the left with Van Blerk and Aurelio Vidmar. Tony Vidmar, Slater on the right. And that's the way to play them. Just keep the cool. We've had six or seven chances. It hasn't gone in. Not time by any means to start the panic yet, but just to get the head up. This is always a dangerous time, just running in towards half time. Keep the concentration at the back and keep playing exactly the same way they are at this stage.
Yallop's free kick. It's open up there, but it's fallen again for Mitchell. Away by Ivanovic Hooper. Trying to get past Van Blerk. The poise and the class at the back by Ivanovic. Arnold. Arnold will get there. The captain laying it across for Tony Vidmar. Zelic. A deep ball for Arnold. Away by Watson. Hooper chasing Vidmar. He'll jockey it out. Well, it's about four or five fouls too late. This is rather petty from the referee to push the ball right back, because the foul would have been at least 2 or 3 metres in. Maybe the referee's a bit tired, let's have a breather. The game has been pretty fast. Van Blerk, free kick. Right over the top of Tobin as well. Mobilio. Aiming for Bunbury. Bunbury got in there ahead of Ivanovic. And look at this. Mitchell was coming through on the right, but Ivanovic has put it up. Farina, the keeper's off his side. Farina, the keeper blocks. Vidmar's there for Australia. Now Arnold. And Hooper away. What can one say? Vidmar. The ball inside. Oh! That's a great ball inside by Vidmar. Farina with a goalkeeper to beat. But as you said earlier, John, important for them not to lose their cool here.
Well, it's a big miss by Frankie, but great work from Aurelio Vidmar. They're opening them up so easily. And it goes without saying, they just need to put this all-important first one away. Some eight or nine opportunities Australia's had in this first half. Getting at the stage, Andy, where you just really have to put one away.
Eight attempts on the Canadian goal, all of them close to resulting in a goal. All good chances. Farina. That's a great ball inside, and Arnold was waiting for it. Hooper got the header away.
That's a good sign from Farina. I mean, you miss a couple of chances, the tendency is to start to hide, but Frank throwing himself around, that was excellent work. Just bad luck it didn't reach Arnie. But it's a good sign that a player, even though he misses the opportunity, is not going to start hiding. Well done, Farina.
Slater's corner. Morris really should have come for it. Van Blerk does. Came off Yallop. Babilio and Vidmar. Tony Vidmar this time. Well, he had to give a free kick there. Tony Vidmar was challenged by Mobilio. They're giving away a lot of free kicks, Canada now. Just about 10 minutes left. And off Arnold. Some of the reserves there from the left, Paul Wade, Jason Pollack, David Mitchell and Dominic Longo. Wade, Pollack and Mitchell involved in the last campaign. Slater up. He'll get away from Sweeney. Throw in for Australia. Tony Vidmar's got a long throw. Arnold's coming across. Samuel staying with him. Farina, touch on. And Van Blerk was coming. He was still there. It would have been on for him. Watson away. Djurakovic. Farina. Aurelio Vidmar. And maybe the first time shot. Slater again. Zelic. Dangerous deflection. Now Hooper back for Canada. Well, Canada are playing like there's about 10 to go and they hang on to the result from the first leg. They've been under enormous pressure in this first half. No penalty there, really. And on to Slater. The Lons player, they value him at around $2 million on the transfer market in Europe. He signed a new three-year deal a few months ago. Ivanovic, Tobin inside, that's confident play. Djurakovic goes long for Arnold. Van Blerk again, typically following through on the left. Not enough height on that, it goes straight to Vidmar though. Farina wants it this time. The ball for Slater. Mitchell. Dasovic. Haven't seen too much of him in the first half. Miller. Bunbury. And here's Dasovic. And it was Ivanovic. Arnold looks up for support. Ivanovic hasn't a man near him for at least 20 metres. Van Blerk. Arnold. Van Blerk's toying with the idea of Slater down that left. Slater easily gets away from Sweeney. In comes a delightful ball, and Watson was there for Canada. Well, it's corner number six. That summed it up today, John. Six corners for Australia.
It was a boxing match. It stopped the fight, but unfortunately it doesn't reflect on the scoreboard. But again, good play. Slater really giving Sweeney the run around.
Craig Forrest has pulled off two saves in particular. The Vidmar block and the Arnold save as well. He's pushed it around the post. Drakovic, Ned Zelic, Farina. Well, that was again a blatant foul there from Samuel, and I don't want to say anything, John, to criticise referees, but in all fairness, the yellow card should have been produced at least 20, 25 minutes ago. Well, fouls like that around the penalty area in their own defensive third.
Well, they've been allowed to get away with it, and while they're allowed to get away with it, you'll keep doing it. So,
Tobin, Arnold, Farina, Vidmar at deep. Three of them have made a run. There goes Vidmar. And two deep in fact. Maybe the ball should have come in a bit earlier. Craig Forrest will be relieved if the scoreline stays like this after 45 minutes. There's around 5 minutes of normal time left in this first half.
I'm sure coach Bob Lenarduzzi would be happy for half-time too, because Canada, looking from their perspective, they really have to do a lot more when they're in possession of the ball. Not that from the Australian point of view we're looking at that so much, but they really just haven't had a lot to offer once they've got possession of the ball. Real desperation stuff like that.
Commitment from Australia again.
Been a real commitment without the ball.
Yeah, Drakovic was trying it. Oh, Vidmar rather. Tony Vidmar. A desperate lunge to keep it in. How have you seen his first game at right back?
Yeah, it's been quite good. It's always a risk to switch players from left side where he normally operates to the right side. It just unbalances some. But he's slotted into it very comfortably.
And again, another corner. To give you a comparison, John, seven corners for Australia now, eight attempts on goal, no corners for Canada, and just one attempt when Mitchell had the chance in the seventh minute. Will this be the goal for Australia? Tobin trying to knot it on.
That's what we're talking about with Canada, Andy. Just getting rid of the ball. Unless they're going to do a lot more with it, they're not going to pose many problems to Australia.
first reaction, it is a penalty. And playing at home, it is a penalty. And that's ironic. Farina complains and gets the yellow card. Farina has been fouled at least on half a dozen occasions. And easy to criticise referees. It did appear a penalty.
And that, John, is Farina's second yellow. He got booked in the first game in Edmonton. So he misses the next one. We'll have a look at the replay.
I don't think there's any doubt it's a penalty, Andy. If you're playing away from home, you probably don't get it, but playing at home especially is a penalty. And sympathy for Farina. He's been kicked all day with no yellow card for the offenders. The frustration comes out in yelling at the referee and he gets the yellow. I mean, that is quite incredible.
Well, Mr. Obata is the second youngest referee, FIFA referee from Japan. And there's got to be questions asked about his performance. They've come so close on 9 occasions. Van Blurk, Farina. He's got the measure of these defenders. Not this time. And a clever play by Mitchell, but Zelic read that play well. Zelic, Aurelio Vidmar. The ball for Arnold, inside for Farina. And now Farina again, the corner. Well, what does a player have to do to score a goal here? Australia have done everything except celebrate a goal. It stays at 0-0. The frustrations continue, particularly for Frank Farina. Forrest comes. Away by Novilio. Ivanovic inside. The flag stays down. Farina is down on the ground at the moment. Here comes the ball. And the numbers coming through. He should have hooked it back a bit more, Slater. And Yallop having a few words to say to Vidmar. Well, that's very unsportsmanlike from the Canadians, having a few words to say to Vidmar like that. The corner taken quickly. Vidmar up. Farina!
Anyone deserved to score, it was Farina. And for any young players watching, a great lesson. Farina has thrown himself around today. He's had a few opportunities he perhaps should have put away, but he didn't lose his confidence. He just kept at it, and that is a spectacular goal, and no one deserved it more than Farina. Booked unjustly for the yellow card, the scissors kick. That is a great goal. Well done, Frank Farina.
That's a goal he'll never forget. 1-0 Australia. Slater, the deadly ball inside. They all went up. Vidmar got the touch. Farina with a bicycle kick. The Socceroos are ahead. And we'll just get some comments from a man, an interested spectator. A man who should be out there today. He'd be disappointed he isn't. Robbie Zabica.
G'day, Andy. How are you? What a tremendous goal, eh? I almost fell off my chair about 8 times, and I finally did in the last, so it's just fantastic for Australia. 1-0 up, good on you.
How do you feel being in the stands? A different perspective from up here?
Oh, of course, yeah. I'd love to be out there, but that's not to be. The guys have just shown tremendous spirit. The only magical ingredient we didn't have was a goal, and finally it came. And before time, just before half-time, look at that. It's half-time already. Fantastic.
Can they go on with it, Robbie?
For sure. Let's look at 2 or 3.
Okay, Robbie, we'll get some closing comments on the first half from Johnny. It's been a half where Australia dictated the pattern of play. It took them so long to score. It came just seconds after the 45 minutes was up. Frank... Australia running from the left to the right-hand side. A busy first half for them. They do have the goal to show for it. Frank Farina scored his 10th goal for Australia. Bunbury, again, the familiar shadow of Tobin right on him. Mark Schwarzer has had very little to do, in fact, just the one save. There'll be no complaints from the Marconi Goalkeeper of the Year. Plays with the Coca-Cola Soccer League champions, Marconi Fairfield. Do you expect the same intensity that we saw in the first 5 or 10 minutes in this?
Well, it has to be. They ideally kill them off. The interesting change by Canada means it's more attacking sort of formation for them. They really have to come out now, because a 1-0 loss doesn't do them any good. And in coming out, one believes it's going to create more opportunities for Australia.
Well, the keeper, I'm surprised he hasn't come off his line confidently today. He's stood still, and that was really a ball for him to come out to. Van Blerk, just down there by Yallop. Ipswich Town teammate of Forrest's. Vidmar. He had an outstanding season with Vardegem in Belgium. Same could be said about Zelic at Borussia Dortmund. Tony Vidmar. The touch by Arnold for Zelic. Zelic gets the better of the captain, Miller. It's with Arnold now, and they get yet another corner. The 10th corner of the game for Australia. Hard to work out what sort of crowd we have. I would estimate around 30,000. Maybe a bit more. But a great attendance here at the Sydney Football Stadium for one of the most important games in Australian soccer history. Van Blerk in, and Farina went for it. Now Tony Vidmar inside Farina, and it bounces over.
Oh no, it's not going to happen again. Frank Farina can't believe it. Either can the fans, either can the co-commentator, the former Socceroo captain Johnny Warren.
Well, Frank knows it better than anyone else. Harder to miss than put it away from there.
Just one more goal, I would suspect John would kill the game off and wrap it up for Australia. But then again, Australia just cannot afford to concede one. At the moment, it's 2-2 on aggregate, but Australia would go through to the next round on the away goals rule. In went Ivanovic. Important for Milan Ivanovic not to concede a yellow. He was booked against the Solomon Islands earlier in this campaign. Already Farina has been booked over two legs now against Canada. Mitchell. Schwarzer with his eye on the ball, but hit the box and take. Bunbury came charged through. Farina, Vidmar coming through. That's a good ball. Arnold's gone deep.
Get up.
There's Slater, the Lons midfielder. Deflection. Good take by Forrest. Ivanovic, Dasovic, in was Jurakovic there on Mitchell. So Mitchell's moved into the centre of the midfield. Hooper's gone wide, and Valentine has combined with Mitchell in the centre there. They've made some changes to their midfield formation. Slater, Farina, Zelic. He's got Van Blerk free on that left. Hooper and Van Blerk. Aurelio Vidmar's back there. Looking for Farina. And away by Watson. Oh. Bunbury has built the free kick there. Dasovic, Hooper, overlapping is Yallop. There's numbers in the box for Canada at the moment. Yallop, no chance at all there for Canada.
That move, Andy, indicates the different Canada we're going to see in the second half, throwing a lot of men forward. They have to get back in this game now, and in doing that, it's going to create more opportunity, I believe, for Australia at the other end.
The counter-attack,
it's quite simply a matter of taking chances. We're at 11, 9 or 10 chances so far, and they've really got to be taken to really knock Canada off. I mean, it's been all Australia, but still the game's in the balance.
Valentine gets it back from Yallop. Now Hooper runs straight into Farina. Valentine. Again, Ivanovic has the easy job. The ball for Farina, the keeper comes. Well read this time by Forrest. Been a bit unsure coming off the line, and Dasovic, he's managed to keep it in. Ivanovic and Bunbury. Well, I think the experience of playing in England has given Bunbury a bit of advantage in these 50-50 balls. He really, I don't think there was any doubts that perhaps Miller did concede the foul there, but Bunbury is a craftsman and
knows how to milk a free kick.
He knows, he definitely knows, and he would have learnt that in England. Valentine's cross blocked by Ivanovic. Yell at the long searching ball. Samuel's up there, so is Bunbury. He joined West Ham midway through last season. They were promoted to the Premier League. He's played in all the games in this qualifying phase for Canada. In fact, Bunbury was the first Canadian to score a hat-trick in international football. That was a couple of years ago against Bermuda. Zelic. And he gets the throw-in. Surrounded by three players. And Zelic shows us his class. Sweeney's been doing that all day, and there was no need for Watson to run across anyway. You know, he gives a yellow for Farina. That's absolute stupidity, because I know that Robbie Slater should not have retaliated there, but when you get kicked up the park,
clearly a tackle from behind. The danger for Slater is that he retaliates and gets the yellow.
Free kick, bit of pushing, yes. There's a couple of Socceroos there, nudging. Frank Farina scored a goal for Strasbourg in the first round of the French competition, then joined up with the Socceroos. Tobinon, Arnold, couldn't get it back for Slater. Slater got in there. Love lost between Slater and Sweeney. That's a dangerous looking ball for Hooper. And Schwarzer, it's gone in! What was Schwarzer doing there? He should have pushed it around. Canada are back on level terms here now. Hooper, the scorer. He should have palmed it around. And Canada now have the upper hand. Australia now have to score two goals and not concede another. Or if they can score again, it'll go into extra time.
Funny game, as they say, Andy. Canada have not been in the game at all. And now, of course, we have the situation where Australia have to score twice, or at least once, to take it into extra time. And caught out at the back, but all it takes is one mistake, despite the superiority of Australia and the opportunities. It's a big ask for them now.
Well, they've had so many opportunities to add to this score. There's plenty of time left. There's 35 minutes left in the game. They have to regroup and grab this second. And the goal will make such a difference to the Canadians now. Valentine. Yellow. On by Van Blerk. Ivanovic to Zelic. Ivanovic through for Arnold. Smart play again by Forrest. Slater. Dasovic now for Canada. Mitchell across to Bunbury. You can see the change in the Canadian play now. The scorer, Hooper. To Yallop. Down the line is Valentine. Ivanovic. He's played well today for Australia. Farina, who's onside. Farina and Watson, only Arnold up there to support him. Farina should take Watson on. Farina. Good idea, but just running out of space. We've seen Farina win a penalty in the exact same position against Argentina. That was back in 88. It'll be a real test now for Australia. How they react to that equaliser. Vidmar was fouled earlier. Jurakovic and Aurelio Vidmar this time. And Aurelio keeps it in. Van Blerk. Yallop. Good block by Arnold. Zelic. He's got Arnold and Farina. Zelic might go it himself. Then Zelic goes with it. And he miscues at the final hurdle. Unlike Ned Zelic, the first time we've really seen that run from him.
But a great run, the type of thing Ned's got to do more often. Australia needs him doing that now. tough times. He's just such a beautiful dribbler of the ball, able to glide past opponents. And as the game goes on, Australia needs more and more of that from Ned.
Waved play on, the ball was still in. Mitchell. Schwarzer takes it comfortably. Slater. And straight through the middle. Again, Canada have won a bit of possession in the middle now in the last 5 or 10 minutes. And Yellup, great work from the veteran. Ivanovic. Sweeney on, that'll go out. Well, no yellow card, the fouls continue. Vidmar looking for Arnold. Hooper on. Jurakovic in there now. Dasovic. Tobin away. Mitchell. And that'll be a yellow.
Which is a correct decision. It's a professional foul, but it seems ironic, doesn't it? You get a foul for handling the ball. You can kick all day as a Canadian defensive. Got away with what they've been able to by the referee. But a little bit of... doesn't seem fair, does it, Andy, when you get the handball to yellow. But it's been a better second half from Canada. Lena Ducey, the coach of Canada, last in the first game, changed things at halftime. He's changed again today with good results. It seems to suit Canada better to come forward and have a go at Australia rather than to sit back.
The first corner of the game for Canada. Australia have had 11. The most important statistic. It's Australia 1, Canada 1. Back to where they started again. They need a goal to keep this tie alive. Schwarzer looked like the touch had come off the keeper. That's what Bunbury's asking. Smart goal kick. Slater. Three Australians up there with him. On his left is Van Vleuten. Zelic wants it inside. Jurakovic. Here's Tony Vidmar. Slater's taken off. Valentine is with him.
Get out! Get out! Get out!
Tobin, will he go long? Arnold should win the header here. Vidmar. Too strong for Jurakovic. Slater comes across. And Valentine. Just taking the pressure momentarily away from his defence. Up was Watson. Farina and Samuel. Not really the best of clearances by Valentine. Zelic. He was looking for Vidmar. And now Mitchell. He's got Bunbury on his left. Ivanovic. Kidmo, it starts all over again for Australia. Just wondering about the long balls, John, whether that's perhaps the best way they're trying to...
Well, it's not the best way. The best way is to play as they did in the first half. But the players starting to get a little bit anxious, Andy. Time's still not crucial, but the Canadians sensing that the start got Australia a little bit under pressure. Australia has to score twice, or once at least, to take it into extra time. But there's the time for the cool heads.
25 minutes left. Australia really haven't put enough pressure on this Canadian goal in the second half. Great steal by Farina. And he's got to be joking. Samuel just pushed Farina away. And the referee's allowing too much to go on, which... No disrespect to the Japanese officials, but this is a very amateurish refereeing exhibition. And for a crucial World Cup qualifier, questions have to be asked as to why they've decided to get Japanese officials. What poise by Zelic. And over the top by Zelic. But as you said earlier, it's important for him to get involved.
The beauty of Zelic, able to glide past the opponent. Sure, the shot is not what he likes, but Ned, or Australia, needs a lot more of those taking chances like that from Zelic. Back to the referee, Andy. I mean, once you set the standard early on and allow players to get away with certain things, it's very hard later on to tighten up. I think that's the mistake that he's made.
The back pass rule. And no one's coming through to test Forrest rather. Vidmar. Aurelio getting the better there of Yalop. Farina. Has got away with what you could say, to use a cliche, murder. That's, I think now on my calculations, his sixth or seventh foul, and not a yellow yet.
And particularly that one, it is a professional foul. Farina through.
That's the second time Farina's been on his way. Second time he's been brought down viciously. Crowd trying to urge their team on. Good take by Forrest. The crowd, 25,982. A little bit disappointing. They have created a bit of an atmosphere. Or wasn't there a bit of climbing on the back there of Arnold? Slater. Van Vleuten. Well, what was Samuel? Surely he was hanging on to Van Vleuten there. Didn't know where the ball was and went to the player. The danger of the counter from Canada. Zelic. Up was Yalop. Valentine. Drakovic there for Australia, Aurelio Vidmar. And it's, well, it's taken how long? 24th minute of the second half. And the captain goes into the book. The referee saw that one. Van Vleuten. was off the body, I think, of Sweeney. Jurakovic to Slater, inside, and not enough really to... Vidmar was coming through, so was Arnold. ...20 minutes of normal time left. Do or die for Australia at the Sydney Football Stadium. Arnold on. Karina. Back pass. Good clearance. Great clearance from Forrest, finding Mitchell. Sweeney, a veteran from 86, Mexico finals. And Bunbury will kick that in. So. The experienced legs of Ivanovic charging on for Australia. Arnold. Ooh, touch and go. Yes, I would think offside. It's been interesting today. Arnold hasn't had the opportunities that he would have liked. They've really fallen to the likes of Farina and Vidmar. Arnold is the top scorer in this team for Australia. He's put away 16 goals in 43 internationals. Farina scored today to make it 10. Dasovic, and away by Jurakovic. Arnold and Samuel. Tobin on. Zelic. Aurelio Vidmar on his left. And Farina and Watson. Valentine back for Sweeney. Mitchell running through the middle. And the header on. He's onside. And just missed. By Bunbury, although the referee has spotted a foul in that box. Bunbury on Van Bloerk. Now the clock is against Australia. 17 minutes of normal time left. Australia have only made it to the World Cup once, back in 74, in crucial home legs. In the last few campaigns, they've fallen at this identical hurdle. Drew against Israel 4 years ago here, they had to win. The campaign before that in 85, they drew against Scotland, they needed to win. And before that, back here in Sydney, but at the cricket ground, they lost to New Zealand and they had to win. Same story here as well, they have to win.
I guess for Australia's point of view, Andy, got to get back more to trying to open them up on the sides. They did it so well in the first half. They're starting to get a little bit anxious and trying to go through the middle, trying to take the direct route. And once you do that, you're going to play into the hands of Canada. Just settle it down and try and spread it wide. Get Van Bloerk involved on the left, Vidmar and Slater on the right, and try and open them again. That's when they were doing so well.
Interception by Samuel. Mitchell. Dasovic. Sweeney. Totally different Canada this half. Dangerous play by Jurakovic. And the most experienced campaigner for Australia, David Mitchell, made his international debut back in 1981. Will be coming on soon. And the player coming off is, in fact, Robbie Slater. No. Well, the referee has waved play on, so Slater has to stay on. We've seen it all today, John. Slater, I mentioned earlier in the telecast, had a hamstring problem. Suffered a training last night. There were some question marks earlier today whether he would be starting. Arnold miscued, but still Van Bloek in there. And the change is being made now. Robbie Slater off, succumbing to that hamstring problem. Dave Mitchell, who's put away 11 goals for Australia. They'd love him to score just one here to keep the tie alive. Formerly of Swindon Town, who were promoted to the Premier League, he's joined the Turkish club Izmir. The first change for Australia. Mitchell with a good interception. Play on. Vidmar. He's got Farina on the right. He goes for Mitchell. Samuel back there. It's still on for Jurakovic. Novak Jurakovic has found goal and he's shot the roof career. And he'll never ever score a more important goal than that. And the goal was all Jurakovic. He took the free kick quickly. The play went up the other end. Mitchell's telling challenge for the ball. Jurakovic saw the keeper off his line. And Australia are well and truly in the game now, John.
You could deny that they've deserved it overall. Things were starting to look grim, but great to see Jurakovic score. He's for me one of the performers for Australia. Good challenge from Mitchell. We're talking about Samuel and criticising him for some of the fouls, but he's been a great performer for Canada. But thankfully that's in, and Australia back in it.
And look at Mitchell. That was a challenge off the ball as we were watching the replay. It looks like Sweeney, the number three, was booked. Now has... Farina offside. Mitchell's back on the pitch. There was an incident as we were watching the replay. It's become a war out there either way. The tie is level. If it stays like this, it'll be... comes another extra time scenario, and if it's level after that 30 minute extra time period, a clash there with Sweeney and Mitchell. I don't think Sweeney will come back into the game. Canada with 10 men, Sweeney has to really get that looked at. It'll require stitches. Ivanovic. Smart play. Didn't give away a throw in. Farina right now. No. Deflection either way. Very important for Australia not to lose their rhythm. But what about that? Oh, he's got to give him a card, please. Surely. Well, Mr. Bata. I don't want to really give a go at this referee, but he wouldn't be able to referee a fifth division match in the New South Wales State League after his performance today. There's been nothing really given. You know, I'm not being biased.
No, it's a professional foul. Denial of a goal scoring opportunity is a red card offence. That is a FIFA directive. We saw Robbie Zabika sent off last week. The strict interpretation of that is exactly that.
Offside. Offside. Vidmar was offside. 10 minutes left in this drama-packed game at the Sydney Football Stadium. What was the old saying? Soccer's not a matter of life and death, it's more important than that.
I feel sorry for Farina. He's been fouled all day. And one of the few players to get a yellow card for opening his mouth.
Mitchell through for Bunbury. Corner kick. Normal time left. The Australian defence has to regroup now. Dreams, the hopes of a nation resting on these gallant Socceroos. They fought their way back. Still by Schwarzer, away by Farina. Arnold chasing. Cooper back there. Mitchell should keep it in if he plays it quickly. No. Clearing kick, straight to Yallop. It was Hooper. Bunbury there ahead of Djurakovic. Farina. Well, at least it's a throw-in for Australia. Canadians are much more physical than the first leg. They can't really match Australia for skill. And Mitchell! Samuel was the player down as Mitchell came through. Still there with 10 men. Sweeney still hasn't come out of the dressing rooms. Samuel the player down at the moment. This extra man advantage, Australia really need to try and capitalise as quickly as possible. What do you think, John, the remaining few minutes?
Well, Canada not making the change because of the possibility of extra time, aren't they? They've already made one change to make another one now. They can't freshen the team up. But I think the key injury is that one there to Samuel. We've criticised him for the fouls on Farina, but he's had a ripper of a game for Canada, the heart and soul of the defence.
Yallop. Bunbury back there. Middle through. That's a great ball for Dasovic. And it's been given as a goal kick. That came off Vidmar. That should have been a corner. Australia get a bit of a good decision. Level on aggregate of 3-3. Could go to extra time, and Ruschel slipped there by Jurakovic, and another one there by Bunbury. And Milan Ivanovic, for mine, John, perhaps the best player for Australia today. Zelic, Farina, Bidmark coming through. Farina might go it alone. Farina! Well, wide of the mark in the end. He's had a few opportunities today. That one well wide. One of the most celebrated Australian players. Joining me and Johnny up here has been the most interested spectator, the suspended keeper, Robbie Zabica. Robbie, how do you see it now?
Oh, it's just unbelievable stuff here. You know, hopefully we can get this the third goal, which is the most important one. But then again, we have to just try and hold out as well, you know, make sure we don't get a goal against us.
Farina back now for Bidmark. Looking for Arnold, and that could have just deflected back for Arnold or either Tony Vidra or Farina, but great character to come back, Robbie.
Yeah, thank you, tremendous. You know, he's all heart, just been terrific.
You put that down to fatigue, the fitness factor now?
Yeah, I felt the, you know, our boys really put in a lot the first 45 minutes, and, you know, they were sort of really sucking in the air at the end of the 45. So hopefully, you know, there's no doubt they must, you know, they're fit enough for the whole game. So there's not a problem there.
Ivanovic, you'd be delighted being an Adelaide City teammate.
Yeah, he's a class player.
Jurakovic, who kept Australia in the game with that delightful header, is looking for Mitchell. Mitchell, inside for Vidmar. Numbers are back there. Jurakovic. And no one coming through at the keeper. And it's turned into a superb ball for Mitchell. Arnold back there stealing from Bunbury. They're offside at the moment. Farina Zondo. Farina. A save by Forrest. Vidmar. Oh, what a save by the keeper. Tremendous work from Forrest. He's kept Canada alive as well. First it was Farina. And then it was Aurelio Vidmar. He's kept it in. Mitchell in the centre. Aurelio Vidmar with him. Van Blerk inside. Handball. At the edge of the area. Miller. Well, just seconds ago it looked like it was going to be the victory Australia so richly deserved. But Forrest, who off his line has been a bit dicey here, with two great saves. One minute and 3 seconds of normal time left in the game. As it stands, it will go into extra time. But Australia, they could have wrapped it up just seconds ago. A blatant handball, the referee just waves play on. Mitchell, it's a dangerous looking ball, Watson away. Tobin up. Zelic. Arnold. Ooh, that could be... No, it's not dangerous this time. Djurakovic has got numbers on the right. Farina. There's men inside. Farina. Farina. Mitchell. Blocked. The scissor kick wasn't on. Arnold was waiting. And Australia... Let's hope they don't rue the fact that they haven't been able to take these chances, John.
Well, I think for any neutral observer, Andy, that they had the opportunities, this is one of those things they haven't been able to put them away. Yeah, unfortunately, in the final analysis, it doesn't count. Canada is still alive. Now the question of extra time, who's going to be better equipped to cope with it?
What a saviour Djurakovic was. With 13 minutes to go, the unlucky number has been a lucky one for Australia, because they still are in this tie. 3-3 on aggregate. We're playing now a minute of injury time. Will it be a dramatic finish to the game from Farina? Farina can't get past Watson. Sweeney. Australian throw in. The Coca-Cola Socceroos. Farina couldn't get that touch back there. Djurakovic. And Bunbury. Well, he's given Djurakovic a yellow card for standing on the ball. Well, if you wanted to write down his number, why did he have play to continue? He's writing it out now, but that's another yellow for Australia. Vidmar, Farina, and remember Djurakovic. 2 minutes of injury time up. Sweeney. Vidmar, the back pass. Schwarzer confidently away. Van Bloerkon. Vidmar. Inside for Zelic. Zelic. Oh, it was on for Arnold or Farina. Gee, it looked like... Now Mitchell shakes his man in Samuel. Mitchell. But just moments earlier, John, it looked like Zelic was almost going to get it across on that right, but there were two men. And that goal has lifted the Australians, as the referee, I'm surprised, has allowed this much injury time. That should really be it. So it's down to extra time. Lisa Obata from Japan, again, signals the restart. First period of extra time. 15 minutes each way. If it's still locked at this scoreline, it'll go to penalties. Australia in that first 90 minutes had 17 attempts on goal. They could really use a player like Slater, but they haven't really lost that much in Mitchell.
No, not at all. Mitchell's just been terrific. Unfortunate again, he got a knock in the first 5 minutes he came on, but he's still out there fighting, you know, that's true grit.
Valentine, the only change made by the Canadians. And look at the space Bunbury has. And Schwarzer got down to that one. It's hard really not to be too critical of Mark, because the goal they scored, he really should have grabbed that one or pushed it around. But yeah, it's one of the lessons of international football.
Oh, for sure. You know, it's just great for Mark to be out there. You know, 3 weeks ago, you know, he was in Sydney just relaxing. So he's out here playing a World Cup, and, you know, he's only 20 years of age.
and he's just a great goalkeeper, player of the future.
Thank you, Robbie Zabica, one of the guest commentator today, and a man who would have been out there but for the unfortunate incident in the first leg in Canada. Ivanovic, a real inspiration today. Bunbury drops. Yalapon. Ivanovic. Ooh, that's the first mistake by him. As Valentine marched straight through. Arnold noticeably dropping back for Mitchell. Which is a good move, really. Arnold's accustomed to that role as well. Mark Schwartz's last international was here against Israel in a World Youth Qualifier before the 1991 Portugal World Youth Championships. Farina's onside. Watson back. Ivanovic, Arnold, the two front men are up there, ready. The long ball for Mitchell, Samuel keeping his eye on it. Mitchell waits for the support. Vidmar, inside is Arnold. Arnold still going. Just maybe I thought Arnold might have tried it first time. That was a good build-up by Australia. Vidmar, Van Blerk, did a lot of running, particularly in that first half. And he gets the corner. Third corners for Australia and just two for Canada. Vidmar got up there, but it was away by the captain, Miller. Bunbury. Ivanovic. As cool as ever, the former Red Star Belgrade campaigner. Arnold. That's a good ploy. Open up the Canadians. That's a good ball for Mitchell. Mitchell, the keeper to beat. Oh, it should have been the goal again for Australia. Farina will keep it in. They just needed a touch as well at the back post. Vidmar. And they can't get it across this time, but the chance goes begging for Australia. Oh, well wide of the mark by Tony Vidmar, in fact, a throw in. But it's been surprising. Australia have created so much, but they just haven't been able to finish.
It's been the story of the game, hasn't it, Andy? It's easy to sit here and be critical, but there have been so many opportunities. This was a game Australia should have had well wrapped up before full-time. Fortunately, the facts are it's not. It's a question now of who is going to be mentally stronger. The legs are tired now. It's a question who wants to get there the most. You sense that physically Australia perhaps in a little bit better shape than Canada.
Van Blerk, the man who had committed the foul on Bunbury. And You've got to pay credit where it's due. Bunbury has done so much work, particularly off the ball. He's dropped back to help his midfield. He's chased. He's been closely tagged by Tobin. Vidmar and Hooper. Vidmar has the height advantage. And a miscue by Van Blerk. That's dangerous. And Hooper came through. Vidmar shakes his man in Miller. And a blatant block by Sweeney. Sweeney's already booked. No. Play on. Here comes Bunbury. Mitchell. There was Ivanovic. They've got to clear it away. No direction, no power. Easy work for Schwarzer. That was really an ideal opportunity for Canada. And Paul Wade, it looks like, will come into this game. Zelic, it looks like, is the man who's going to come off. As Mitchell and Samuel chase. Through comes Arnold. He's hit it too long. Well, the referee has finally decided to let the change happen. He was looking over here earlier. Zelic was walking across. And now he's ready to make the change. Well, that's really good. For Ned Zelic. He comes out of the game. The former captain, Paul Wade, comes in. And Wade has a few points to prove to the coach. After missing the last three. So Australia have made two changes. And just the one by Canada. A Valentine for Mobilio. Sweeney. Tobin on for Farina. Away by Watson. Vidmar drops. That's a great looking ball for Farina. And Forrest read the play very well. Arnold, Mitchell calling for it. Through comes Mitchell, the keeper should come. That might be a dangerous, well it wasn't. Well done by Yallop. And Ipswich Town defender gets the ball back. In was Ivanovic. Wade. Van Blerk. Vidmar down the line. It needed to be a bit quicker. And either way, it's a throw-in for Canada. 5 minutes left in this first extra time period. Delightful ball there for Valentine. Farina. Away goes Vidmar. Didn't really turn out to be an advantage for Australia. You wonder why the referee allowed it to go on for so long. And that's a free kick for Canada. Well, double standards really, because I can't see where Rinne Vidmar has such an advantage when three Canadian defenders are in front of him. And at the other end, Canada have the free kick. Schwarzer, very strong in the air, very confident. He's picked up his game after that earlier mistake. Through ball for Mitchell. Away by Forrest. Danger as Vidmar comes across. The keeper's still out of his area, but he gets back now. Wade. Farina making a run. That's a lovely ball. Farina and Samuel. Sweeney came back in cover. The former club Bruges, Bari, and now Strasbourg striker has been in the thick of the action today. Ivanovic. How clever was that? And the pass was beautiful for Farina. Samuel and Farina. Dangerous play by the Socceroo. Who would want to be a coach?
Yep, not the easiest job in the world. But it's when we look at our favourite topic, Andy, are going down, if it goes to penalties, it's sad way to decide. You were saying earlier, Canada 14 qualifying games, 4 years for both countries. I think Australia better served if they can really try to open up, to push it down the flanks. I think they're just tending to play a little bit too long through the middle. And there's not a lot of change in doing that.
It's good to see the crowd getting behind the Socceroos. They need all the support. The job still not over. Level on aggregate 3-3. Just shows you how critical that away goal in Edmonton turned out to be. Wade with his eye on the ball, and that's a great header. Farina, and there was Watson. Arnold up. Vidmar. It needs a touch. Farina. Farina! And the keeper got down well. The keeper, after a shaky start, has become a real hero for his country. Why not? On by Bunbury, no one up there except Ivanovic for Australia. Vidmar. Wade. Mitchell through the middle. Van Bloek. No one's in the box. Was that a handball? Well, it looked like it. Arnold. Vidmar's kept the run going. Mitchell's in there as well. Inside for Vidmar. Flags up. We're playing injury time, the first period of extra time. We'll just have a look at the replay here, John. No handball. Noticed that Van Bloek has become a bit more fatigued than the rest of his teammates. Maybe paying the price for a lot of running in the first 90 minutes. This is ominous. Vidmar. Game long again for Farina. Watson, good forceful header away. Well, he's playing a minute and 30 of stoppages in this first period of extra time. Bunbury. Great steal by Tobin. Mitchell. It was almost off of Van Bloem. And there, in fact, is the end of the first period of extra time. It's still a stalemate. Australia lead 2-1, but it's 3-3 on aggregate. With both countries having scored one goal away from home. How did you see the first period, John?
Well, Australia's again, but the problem for them is, Andy, I think that as they're getting tighter, they're not probably not concentrating as much, but they've really got to build up on the side. I feel that if they're going to play long balls through the middle, that they're really going to play into Canada's hands. We've seen Forrest, their goalkeeper, sweeping at the back so well. And if we're going to play through the middle, I think we're going to limit our chances of winning the match. Or certainly winning the tie, one should say. But hopefully it doesn't go to penalties. I think it's going to be sad to see the game decided that way. Looking ahead, it's going to be a difficult assignment for the winner here today. Argentina, Colombia, Paraguay or Peru. And the way that group is shaping, the second best qualifier, it would be at this stage Peru having lost twice at home, Argentina having won twice away, means that the second place team there is most likely to be either Colombia or Paraguay.
Two centre-backs, Watson and Samuel, have kept that part of their country's game together. Here comes Vidmar. Will he take Sweeney on? He does, easily. Vidmar might go all the way. Vidmar straight at the keeper. He could have kept going even closer.
The point is, Andy, that the attack came from the flank, and that's where Australia's got to do it in these last 15 minutes. Open Canada on the side. That's where the space is, that's where the tired legs are too. You go through the middle, they've got the numbers plus the keeper. It's relatively easy to sweep up.
Now Vidmar. Valentine staying with Aurelio Vidmar, which would have just put him off. And Forrest moved quickly again. The Ipswich Town keeper. He's played 170 games for them since he joined back in 1988. It's a big clearance away for Mitchell. Wade. Back for Ivanovic. Ivanovic, player of the game for Australia, I think. Farina. And it wasn't strong enough for Wade. Samuel back there. And it comes off Farina in the end. Farina's done a lot of work today. He's covered a lot of ground. Transferred for 1.6 million to Strasbourg from Bari. Van Bloek should get there first. Vidmar and Hooper. Watson. Well, this is one of the worst exhibitions of refereeing. It's just been too inconsistent. Grant Needham, a striker, is coming on for Canada. And Dasovic goes off. The second change made by the visitors. plays with the Montreal club. Scored 5 goals in 14 games in the current season. Cheer goes around the ground as the referee gets one right. Towering Craig Forrest, 6'5". Certainly got a kick to match as well. Watson on. Djurakovic keeping his eye on the ball. Arnold has dropped back to the midfield. Tony Vidmar. Staying with it. Vidmar. In comes a good looking cross. Wade has kept up there. Wade looks up. High floating ball. Vidmar and Mitchell are in there. So was Sweeney. And now the substitute, Needham. A bit of a miscue. Arnold gets it just in time. Vidmar. Aurelio Vidmar running right through the middle. Aurelio hasn't stopped all day. Not enough on it there for Mitchell. Not the best of clearances. Wade with a great header inside. Mitchell up. No one coming through. Van Vleuten. Just maybe timed his run a bit too slow. And Ivanovic can't keep it in. Djurakovic already has a yellow card in the game. That was a yellow card offence as well, John. That should be a red.
It was a yellow, and we've criticised the referee today. We'll see what happens now. That's a late challenge from him.
And both teams have made 2 changes. There is, when that incident occurred, 10 minutes of normal time left. This is a hard one to call, John. It's just one opportunity to both sides in the first period of extra time, and then Vidmar, 44 seconds. And this is looking much more serious than what we first thought. Djurakovic is down on... And the stretcher coming out. The substitute, Needham, down. And we have a situation where perhaps both teams are going to finish with 10 men. Although Djurakovic is up. No. Well, that's what they were clapping. He's being held up there by the physiotherapist, Pedro Ruiz. Dr. Kanunga is out there as well. But Grant Needham is the more serious of the two.
Plays in his own. What a tragedy for the Canadian team. Needham had been on the field for less than 2 minutes. He'll take no further part. Canada are down to 10 men with at least 10 minutes of normal time left. This was the incident. A clash of heads, you could see there. Then Djurakovic landed on top of Needham. And the most unfortunate way for Canada to finish this second leg at the Sydney Football Stadium. 2-1 Australia lead. 3-3 it's level on aggregate. Farina offside. Well, they've got the extra man now, and Djurakovic is back on the pitch. So John, Australia have the numerical superiority. They have the attacking superiority, but they just haven't scored enough goals. And this should really be a huge bonus for them. They seem to be finishing a bit more stronger. They seem to have a bit more energy left. It just might be best for Canada to drop back and play for penalties. Forrest, the extra sweep, are keeping it in. That can sometimes be a dangerous boy. Wade. Wade's onside. There's the ball. Oh, it took a deflection off Hooper. Across is Yallop. And it's come off Van Bloom. In there's Farina. Throw in for Canada. Well, it's almost identical. Canada had the extra player after Robbie Zabiga was sent off. Needham's down on the sideline, and now Australia have the extra man. Aurelio Vidmar, he's got the captain. Graham Arnold on his right. Well, he should have played it to him. Bunbury came back and stole possession. Aurelio should have knocked it across. The flag up there against the substitute, Carl Valentine. The Adelaide City combination there, Tobin to Ivanovic. Farina. He's got Mitchell. Back inside for Arnold. The shot by Arnold. Just too much underneath it there. The gaps are opening up. Consistent with his inconsistencies. It's Australia now who performed what appears to be a good defensive line there. The runners are being picked up. Ivanovic away. Vidmar with a steal. Hooper, he won't get booked. Even though Vidmar was on his way, he won't get booked. Might get a heart attack with a decision like that. I just can't believe an international like this, the importance of such an international. The refereeing display has just been all over the place. as that attempt by Arnold was as well. On my stopwatch, 13 minutes and 20 seconds into the second period, but I don't stop the watch when there is a delay for injuries or other incidents. So you'd think there would be about 4 to 5 minutes for that horrific clash between Needham and Djurakovic. So there's probably about 8 minutes left. So easy for Forrest. Maybe the short ball would have been a better option there. Yahab. Back to the keeper. Bit of a Higuita from Forrest. And Vidmar was the man caught offside as he was dropping back. It looks like it could be penalties, John.
Well, sadly, it looks like it, Andy. You go back to that first half where Australia should have been half a dozen in front at half-time. So many opportunities. They weren't taken, but it's the way the game goes. Sadly, it's going to go, looks as though it's going to go to penalties anyhow. One wonders why, in a situation like this, it couldn't go to a third match.
Word has come through on Needham's injury. He's heavily concussed. And that's the latest. Thankfully, it's not more serious than that. And Tobin toying around at the back. 3 minutes, I would calculate. 3 to 3.5 minutes. Wade, Tobin, Djurakovic. Wade. Djurakovic onside. Djurakovic could be the hero! It's gone wide. Yallop's there for Canada. And Djurakovic, who had scored the goal that had kept Australia in the game. And about five by Canada. Mitchell. Corner kick. We've had 3.5 minutes of stoppages. Australia are playing against 10 men. Needham out of the game. Heavily concussed. Will it be the dramatic finish? Wade misdirecting the header. He was looking for Farina. There's still time left to prevent it going to penalties. Given 4 minutes and 20 seconds of stoppages. And well taken. Sweet penalty. And he sends the keeper the wrong way as well. And just getting a point through. All of their World Cup qualifiers, Bunbury and Schwarzer. Australia ahead.
should have won. They had it wrapped up in the first half. Heart-stopping stuff to go right down to penalties. But I think any neutral observer would agree that Australia deserved to go advanced today. And a funny game, isn't it? Schwarzer perhaps a little bit of fault with the goal that they conceded in normal play, but two great saves and penalties. And I think there's no doubt Australia deserved to advance. It's now going to be either Colombia or Paraguay, one would think.
They really should have wrapped it up earlier.
Well, they should have. I mean, we missed so many opportunities. It was their game in the first half, and no one knows that more than the players, but that's the way it goes. Canada came back well in the second half. But to go right down to penalties, I think it's sad to see a match end this way. Thankfully, it's Australia, because overall, here today, they did deserve over the two legs to advance to the final stage, which will be against the South American opponent come November.
We'll just see now some words before Robbie Zabica has a quick word. We'll throw now to Michael Tomalaris with a delighted captain in Graham Arnold.
Graham Arnold, no doubt one of the most gutsiest performances ever by an Australian team.
Well, pretty emotional at the moment. We did well up.
Graham, what's going through your mind right now?
Well, it sort of makes up for 4 years ago, you know, which was one of the lowest points of my career, and it was a great effort.
You promised that the team would give their body and soul to win this game, and that's exactly what happened.
Well, I think we got all the doubters off our back. You know, there was people saying that the European guys didn't have their heart in the emblem of Australia. And I think we showed today that, you know, all of us are proud Aussies, and I'm proud of all the boys.
What happens now?
Well, I think we're going to have a party tonight, and Tuesday we're all back to Europe. And waiting for that call for November for South America.
Arnie, you're missing out on the celebrations. Go and enjoy.
Thank you.
We'll be back after this break with Les Murray, who'll talk to Eddie Thompson.